everybody, and thank you for tuning into another one of my sports videos. And as you can see today, we're going to be talking the Detroit Pistons, the injury bug, the issue at point guard, the rotation, and whether this should be solved by making a move in the trade market or free agency or something, some kind of transaction moving forward. So first, can I just talk about how frustrating this team is? Like, we just got embarrassed by the 76ers. Like, absolutely thrashed, embarrassed, dominated. Like, it wasn't even like, it was embarrassing to be called a Pistons fan after that game. And I was out of emotions and stuff. And I saw that Pistons Twitter was going a little crazy and maybe a little too overboard over what happened. But then the next day you go out there, and yes, they were without James Harden, but that's still a playoff team, and they go out there and beat the Rockets. So how can a team go out there and get absolutely manhandled by a 76ers team and then go play a better team in the Rockets and win a game, even though they don't have James Harden, they have Chris Paul? So how does that even happen? Well, I think the main answer you can get from that is lack of effort. That's probably the number one answer you're going to get, is lack of effort from night to night, which has been a problem with this team, that you'll see them play good against one team with full effort, and then the next game they'll go down to another team's competition that's not necessarily on their level, and they go out there and they don't play as hard. I mean, that's a problem that the Pistons have been playing throughout this season, and it's like a storyline that you've heard about the Pistons throughout the years. Like, you can go out there and beat the Warriors, but then you go out there and lose to a bad team. And the 76ers are a bad team, but to get embarrassed like that, like, they were up by 40 points at one point, that's unacceptable. So, I mean, yeah, lack of effort is probably the main reason for these kind of things, that they have to have consistency in how they play and how hard they play night to night. Another issue that they probably ran into is the injury to Stanley Johnson, who probably would have been guarding Ben Simmons most of the time against the 76ers. I think Pistons fans are finally starting to see, the ones that were hating on Stanley, I think they're starting to see what he helps for this team. Even if he's lacking on offense, he's having a bad offensive night, or if he's not playing consistently on offense, he would have been the one guarding Ben Simmons. And as you saw, if you watched the game early on, Ben Simmons was just orchestrating everything. He was manhandling everybody, and there was no way the Pistons could possibly stop him. And obviously, the injury to Reggie Jackson is hurting the Pistons, not just in the 76ers game, but also hurts them in the Rockets game, hurts them in every game they play without him. And as my boy Sham, who is now the new Pistons editor at Piston Power, congratulations, he tweeted out today talking about the Pistons are second to last in offensive rating in December, and coincidence? I think not. And also the former Piston Power editor, who I have mentioned in the past in my videos, because these two are really good follows on Twitter, if you guys haven't already, you guys should go follow them, but he tweeted back at Sham talking about how the Pistons are dead last in the NBA since Reggie Jackson went down. So obviously without Reggie Jackson, the Pistons have been struggling maybe just a tad bit. So the question that your mans have been asking is, what should the Pistons do about this? And your mans' answer for that is, I believe that we should be making a trade very soon, and there's a couple different routes we could take in the trade market that I would be completely okay with. Now, like I said, there's a couple different routes the Pistons could take here. I'll be talking about like a piece moving forward that could push us into the Eastern Conference Finals race. I'll be talking about just a building block legit, like next to Andre Drummond. Are we talking about shedding a contract? Are we talking about just finding a better starter and move Ish back to the bench and try and work that out until Reggie gets back? Or are we talking about a Reggie Jackson, Brandon Jennings kind of trade, when Brandon Jennings goes down and then we go find a new replacement? And I know a lot of people are going to think I'm overreacting by this, but I'm starting to lean towards a Reggie Jackson, Brandon Jennings kind of trade. Now, I'm not saying this is the only trade that could help the Pistons. I think we just need to make a trade to better the team, because I think we have the good foundation pieces. I think we're found with better offense. I think we're moving the ball better. I think we're playing better this year. And I think if we found one more piece, we can make it to the Eastern Conference Finals. So I don't think we should let the injury bug, or just, like, you know, wanting to stay pat, screw us over out of making the Eastern Conference Finals. You should always want to try to make it as far as possible. Even though many people are going to say that we are going to lose to the Cavs if we were to make that far, that doesn't mean you just decide just to give up. You always want to make it as far as possible. Now, considering all of that, I'm going to give my reasoning for why Stan McGunning should at least consider a Brandon Jennings, Reggie Jackson type of trade. Now, a basic argument I could simply just say is that I don't think the Pistons are going to make it as far as Reggie Jackson. We need to find a better point guard for the future if we want to make it farther than we want. But that's not the argument I'm going to make. I'm just simply going to point to last year when we saw Reggie Jackson not at 100% trying to play through an injury, or just not play through an injury, but just like playing when he wasn't a full 100%, and we saw what he looked like, and it wasn't a very good sight for him or the Pistons. And like I said earlier in the video, the Pistons have had a good season so far. They've had some up and downs, but they've had some really high ups. They've also had some really low lows, but this team is playing really good. They have some good pieces, and they seem to be improving as a team. So they have a chance to make noise in Eastern Conference Finals. They can consistently bring effort. So if there's any thought in Stan Van Gundy's mind that Reggie Jackson is going to come back and be any kind of same player that he was last year when he was dealing with an injury, trying to come back, he wasn't 100%. If there's any thought that he could possibly play like that again, the Pistons have to find something else, because letting an injury ruin this type of season, or let you being loyal to Reggie Jackson ruin a season like this, would really piss off half the Pistons fan base, and probably would piss me off too. Now, I know there may be some Reggie Jackson stans that are going to watch this video, so let me just go out of my way and say this real quick. Yes, Reggie Jackson was playing good before his injury. He was playing well for the Pistons. The Pistons were playing well with him. And I was really pleased with the way he was playing. I was happy with the way he was developing throughout the season. But that does not change the fact. Oh, yeah, and by the way, besides that game he got injured in, before then, like the past couple of games, he was not looking so hot. Not to take that against anything he's done this season, but it's still there. But that doesn't change the fact that if he's going to come back and he's going to look anything like last year's Reggie Jackson, he's not going to be 100%. If that's going to hurt this team and stop this team's good season so far, I don't give a crap what he's done throughout the beginning of the season. I care about where the Pistons are going to finish, and I'm not going to stay loyal to him just because of how good he was playing before. They weren't loyal to Brandon Jennings when he was playing good, playing the best career basketball he's played. They weren't loyal to him, so why should I be loyal to Reggie Jackson if playing with him still is going to screw us over in the end and hurt this season that we're having? Now, Stan Van Gundy may just decide to stay pat and say, okay, let's wait for Stanley to come back. Let's wait for Reggie to come back. Let's try to stay around 500, float above the water until they get back, and see how they look when they get back, and hopefully they are the same. I, however, think that would be a major mistake, because Reggie Jackson's probably going to come back after the trade deadline. Maybe he comes before, but he's probably going to come back after the trade deadline just to stay safe. So if he comes back and it's not working out, you can't make any moves to improve the team or like to help the team down the line, because the trade deadline's already passed. So if you don't make a move now as a backup plan, or maybe just a future plan, then you're screwed, because if it doesn't work out, the Pistons are going to struggle down the line. If they even make the playoffs, they'll be like 8th or 7th, and if they make it there, they're going to get beat bad by the Cleveland Cavaliers again, and that's not something I would like to see. And they probably lose in the first round. Not only do we lose Avery Bradley if we don't trade him, we lose Avery Bradley and we probably blow the team up. So that's something I don't really want to go through, because I just want to stay loyal to Reggie Jackson. I'm not loyal to him, I'm loyal to the Pistons. So Stan Van Gundy definitely should probably consider the trade that I'm suggesting. Once again, before I end this video, I just want to say I'm not hating on Reggie Jackson. I'm just saying an option between Ish Smith as our starting point guard or injured and or not 100% Reggie Jackson is two really bad options for the Pistons to be dealing with. So they should probably go out there and trade for a point guard. And if it happens to be, okay, well, Reggie Jackson, you're gone because this guy's better for us, then so be it. Who cares? The Pistons went out anyways then. That's all I have for you guys today. What do you guys think? Do you guys agree with what I think the Pistons should do? Is there another trade out there that you guys think they could do? Do you think there's a specific person they should be looking for? What's the trade route you think the Pistons should do? Do you think they should stay pat? Is there a free agent out there? G League, something? By the way, Dwight Bikes, I really like him. I think he should stay. But anyways, what do you guys think we should do? Let me know in the comment section below, or you can hit me up on my Twitter, as always, at Kukagel up here. Thank you for watching the video. If you liked the video, go ahead and give me a thumbs up down there. While you're at it, go ahead and check out my channel. If you like it, go ahead and hit the subscribe button for me. Go ahead and show your friends, your family, show your friends' family, show your family's friends' family, show everybody you possibly can, try to get my channel spread out there. Thank you for watching the video. I'm Koo. I'll see you guys in my next video. Peace out, everybody.